Reed Boucher, and we were talking to Coach yesterday, and he said, well, you don't really know in a 19-year-old how much he can do until training camp gets here, but I think he said that he does things that you can't teach offensively. How nice is it to have a guy like that in the pipeline?
Well, there's no question, and I agree with Pete. I mean, you can't teach a shot release that he has and a knack for around the net. That's his instincts, it's natural. And then the next step is how that it's applied and you know, what the results are after that.
Is there a chance he could win a job here in training camp, or am I getting way too ahead of way too far ahead?
Well, first of all, I think everybody gets way too ahead of themselves when you talk about a young player coming in. Is there a chance? There's a chance for everybody. There's always surprises, and you allow that to take care of itself. You don't plan on it.
How about defensively speaking? I mean, you have Jelena, who got a taste of it last year. Merrill has been on the outside for a little while, and now he's had a taste of it last year at Albany. These are two guys that everybody's looking at. You talk about your young defensemen and how much they mean to the future of this team.
Well, you know, there's another fellow that he's not here because we allowed him to stay home because of the short span of coming over from Sweden because the camp is so close. That's Urbom. So there's no question those three will play in the National Hockey League. How soon? But we have some other young defensemen here, too, who we're very happy about. So it's going to be a very interesting training camp.
Well, I don't know if anything was more interesting than last week was. I know that the writers were just asking you about, you know, whether you're done with the roster free agent-wise. Can you just talk about the process over the last week and what may or may not be happening?
Well, first of all, I don't think you're ever done. Wherever you can make yourself better, you try and do that. And it's just a constant evaluation and reevaluation and then opportunity and timing. All of those things have to come into effect, and then you make a decision.
One of the nice stories in camp, Miles Bell, and when you talk to guys, they say, well, who likes to find these diamonds in the rough, give these guys a chance. We talked to him yesterday. He's so appreciative, of course, that his name was finally called. What did you see in him that made it worth bringing him in?
Well, first of all, I had seen him like every other person did in the prospect game in Toronto, and quite frankly, you know, wasn't overly impressed with what I saw at that time, but what transition he's gone through over the last couple of years, both on and off the ice, and mostly certainly on the ice, because off the ice I think is past tense, and how he's improved and the impression he's made on our scouts, who felt the same way I did at that time, our Western scouts, that, you know, he has the ability to do a certain thing, and that's score. He has an NHL shot, which you can't teach, as we talked about Boucher, so it's an upside, and as far as him as a person, we feel very comfortable with him.
Slapshot is kind of a lost art, it seems, in the NHL the last 10, 15 years, but he's got one, and how nice is that to see for all of us who've grown up watching guys with big slap shots, to see one of those kids come along?
Well, I don't think it's only a slap shot, but that's there. It's his, right. It's a release, and the way he can get it off, and the velocity of it as far as from the release. So that's something, but you have to apply it to under certain sort of pressures and all the other things that come into it.